This video is going to be about horizontal and vertical lines. And as you know, a horizontal line is one that goes left and right across. It's like the horizon, which is why it's probably called a horizontal line. A vertical line is one that goes up and down. So what I want to do is look at these lines in terms of graphs and tables of values and equations. So let's start from a graph. Here we have a graph, and I'm going to draw a horizontal line that goes through the 2 on the y-axis. And I could fill in some ordered pairs over here. So like right here, this would be the pair 1, 2. That would be its coordinates. The coordinates over here would be 3, 2. Right here on the y-axis, I would have 0, 2. Everything on the y-axis begins with a 0. Down here, I'd have negative 1, 2. I always end up with the 2 as the second part of my ordered pair, which makes sense because the 2 is the y value, and my y value is always 2. Okay, let's look at this from a point of view of a table of values. So I've got an x and a y, and let's look at negative 1. Well, when x is negative 1, y is 2. How about 0? Well, when x is 0, y is 2. At 1, when x is 1, y is 2. I think there's a pattern going on here. We jump down to the 3. When x is 3, y is 2. So what we can say about this is y is always 2. And a simple way to say that would be with the equation y equals 2. So what that tells us is this. If we have a horizontal line and we want to know the equation for it, all we have to do is look at the y values on that line. The y values will be the same everywhere we look, the y values in the ordered pairs. The x values are going to change, but what we can always say about this is that no matter what, y equals 2. Okay? So for a horizontal line, you're going to have an equation with y equals some number, and that number is going to be the place on the y-axis that your horizontal line passes through. In terms of a table of values, it's pretty boring. The table of values will have, in this case, a y, whatever the constant number is, everywhere in that column, and you can put any number you want in the x column, you'll still get a 2, in this case, in the y column. Okay, let's look at vertical lines. Vertical lines are going to do pretty much the same thing, except that, well, they're vertical. So let's use this line over here at negative 1. I'm going to have a vertical line that goes through x equals negative 1 right here. And if I look at my ordered pairs, well, over here I've got negative 1 and 1. Over here I've got negative 1 and 2. Negative 1 and 3. Down below the x-axis, I'm going to have negative 1, negative 1. Negative 1, negative 2. And of course, on the x-axis, I'm going to have, should be over here, negative 1 and 0. Of course, everything on the x-axis is going to have 0 as its second ordered pair, second part of the ordered pair. Okay, so what I've got here is every one of these ordered pairs begins with negative 1. And again, that makes sense because the first part of the ordered pair is the x value, and the x value everywhere on this vertical line is negative 1. For a table of values, I can put in, actually let's work it backwards. When y is 2, x is negative 1. When y is 1, x is negative 1 when y is 0, x is negative 1. As you can see, x is always negative 1. So if x is always negative 1, what I can say in terms of an equation is x equals negative 1. Okay? So if you have a vertical line and you have to write an equation for it, all you do is see where that line goes through the x-axis. Whatever point it goes through, you're going to have x equals that point. And actually, you can look at any part of any ordered pair, or any ordered pair that's part of that line. Look at the first value. The first value will always be the same. It's always negative 1 here. And that's going to tell you what your x equals. Okay, so that's about it for now. These things aren't really hard. They can get kind of confusing, so make sure you study up on them and you understand them. People love to put them on tests. Take care for now. I'll see you next time.